Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to go over how you can do artifact removal using independent component analysis for EEG data. And I'm going to be running ICA in EEG lab. Probably you're already familiar with EEG lab if you work with EEG data, but it's a plugin for MATLAB. So I already have a data set loaded in, and let me plot the channel data before running ICA just to show you what we're working with. So for this subject, let me change the scale to 75. For this subject, we have two eye electrodes. So we have one capturing vertical EEG, which will capture blinks, and we have one capturing horizontal eye movement that will capture saccades. So as you can see here, especially for the frontal electrodes, when there's a blink artifact, you still see the artifact in especially the frontal electrodes and the other EEG channels, and the same thing with saccades as well. So that's one thing that we're, or two things that we're going to try to remove with the ICA decomposition. Okay, so to run ICA in EEG lab, it's very simple. You go to tools and they go out of their way to put it in blue. So you click run ICA. It will give you a couple different algorithm options to run ICA with. So the standard one is just the first one called run ICA. There's another one called bin ICA. So this is a binary file of the first one. So it has the same algorithm, and actually I read that it will run faster. And then there are other ones. I've also read that basically these different ones all just usually give you the same components, but you can run multiple ones and compare. I'm just going to run the first one called Run ICA. I think when I've tested it, this has only taken my machine a couple of minutes, but if you find that it takes a long time, you might want to consider running the faster version. You just have to make sure that the file path is set correctly to run the second one, but I'm just going to run the first one and I'll see how long that takes. Then this little window pops up. So this is just if you want to stop MATLAB from running. But if you go to the terminal or command window, it will show you that it's working on the ICA. For me, that only took a couple of minutes to run. And once that is done, then you can go to plot, component activation, scroll to plot the actual EEG signal from each component. So in this sample data that I'm using, I have recordings from 23 electrodes. So that's going to produce 23 independent components. So now when you plot or scroll through the component activities, it will have the 23 independent components listed, and the order of the components is based on how much variance they explain per component. So the first one explains the most variance, followed by the second one and the third one, and so on. So as you can see, the first three components seem to be picking up mostly the vertical and horizontal eye movements, including the blinks. So this is one way of looking at which components you want to remove from your data, and you can scroll through this. And then there's another way of looking at this as well. So you can go to Tools, Reject Data Using ICA, and then click Reject Components by Map. I'm going to plot the 23 electrodes or 23 components that I have, and then that will open up this window. And then you can check each individual component by clicking the green button above their topography maps. So if you click number one, for example, this will open up another window that has a power plot, the individual topography map, and an ERP image and an ERP. So if you click on the ERP below the ERP image, it will give you a zoomed up graph of what the ERP looks like. And this is the ERP image, and this is the power plot, like I just said. You can mark any of these independent components that you look at for rejection by clicking the accept button. And so if you click it, it will change accept to reject or vice versa. Once you click OK, you're not actually removing the independent component yet, you're just marking it for rejection. So I'm going to mark the first three for rejection. And so how you decide whether to accept or reject is kind of subjective. If you have two, like my experiment, if you have two electrodes that are measuring blink artifacts or eye movement artifacts, then you probably want to remove at least two components. And then if you want to remove any more than two, you do have to kind of look at the data and justify to yourself, using whatever criteria you want to use, whether to accept or to reject. Also want to look at the electrodes where, or the topography maps where it looks like all the signal or all the variance is coming from one electrode. So let's look at 11, for example. And this doesn't have a nice 1 over F power plot like you would expect from a good electrode. And then if you click the ERP image, this looks like it's mostly picking up noise. So I'm going to mark this one for rejection as well. And I'm going to just leave it there and then just test out what the signal looks like after we take out the artifact from these four components. So I'm going to click OK. Then if I go back to this window, like I said, the components haven't actually been removed yet. So to remove components, you want to go to Tools and then Remove Components. And the ones that I marked for rejection in that previous window are shown here. So I'm going to click OK and have these components removed. And before EG Lab does that, it's going to show you this little confirmation window so you can check what the data will look like before and after you remove the components. So you can either plot ERPs or plot single trials. So I'm going to click plot single trials. And so it says here that the black is the channels before rejection and the red is after rejection. So you can look at if it's going to change the data by removing artifact like you want it to. And let me go ahead and check plot ERPs. So this will open up a window comparing the ERPs before and after. So this looks okay to me. So I'm going to click accept. And then it's going to let you save the file before the ICA is removed and after the components are removed. So I'm going to save it as AIM post ICA and click OK. And that runs really quickly. And now when you plot it, you'll see that the blink artifacts should be greatly reduced or removed completely from the data. I was just running a quick demo, so the artifact removal might not be perfect, but you can see very clearly that we had some crazy blinks before, and now it's been greatly reduced from the data. And this is something that you can kind of test with, if you're not sure if you want to remove one component or not, you can test before and after and compare the data. And yeah, so that's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.